as the owner of one of Kolkata's most prestigious restaurants, do you agree that the right to food is absolute? Anyone should be allowed to eat whatever he or she wants without any government intervention. There cannot be restrictions on beef, pork, any form of meat.
I agree totally. And the reason I do that is food is also a form of expression. What food I eat is a part of me. And therefore, we have different types of cuisine throughout India. We can base it on where we come from. So some parts will not eat a certain kind of food. Some parts will eat a certain kind of food. Some people love their pork. Some people don't have pork. Some people eat beef. Some people don't. Some people hate fish, where we love fish. So it goes on and on. So I don't see any reason why a government should tell us what to do.
Why don't you serve beef or pork at Kewpie's kitchen?
Well, because the kind of food from Bengal I give does not have pork and beef. If I was doing Anglo-Indian food or a different type of food, I would definitely give it. But since I don't do that, and I'm traditional Bengali, I will not serve pork and beef. Even I may have it at my home, but I will not serve it in the restaurant. It doesn't go with the kind of traditional.
So the reason you don't have beef, you're not serving beef, is because you're saying it doesn't go with the restaurant.
Right.
Pradyut, in your hotel in Shillong, do you serve all kinds of meat?
No, we are very sensitive to certain demands. But serving of food is extremely different from what anyone can have in their personal space. I think that was what your original mm-hmm. question was. And we are in the East. And for once, at least I can say that East does not belong to one culture. So we love our pork. Some of them love their beef. Some people eat mithun meat in Arunachal and parts of Nagaland. Some people love fish, especially in Assam, Bengal, and even in parts of Tripura, we love dry fish. Manipuris have an exquisite vegetarian cuisine, which is at par with the best in the country. So I don't think that the government has any job entering our kitchens. The government may tell us, be sensitive in how you slaughter an animal, because we worship them. But you cannot say that this should not be prepared and this is an intrusion in your private space.
It's interesting that a congressman is saying this, because the truth is that the Congress party was the one which also pushed laws against cow slaughter in the 1960s. It was your chief minister in 1960, Sampurananda in Uttar Pradesh, who took on Nehru and insisted that there would be rules against cow slaughter. So are you saying that the Congress party, if it were to ever come back to power, would ensure that the right to food was absolute?
See, I don't speak entirely for the Congress party. I have not become that big yet. But it's also well understood that a committee was constituted in the 60s, which had members from the RSS. And it was to discuss if cow slaughter or cow ban should be complete or not. The committee only met twice and there was no interest taken. So, as you said, former chief ministers, individuals in the individual capacity may have taken on Nehru, may have taken on Indira Gandhi, but the fact is that the Congress, the party which I know of, has never tried to infringe in your kitchen. And there may have been figures who have tried to impose it in a personal capacity for their personal community or caste-based vote. But as in party, I think we are far less intrusive than what you see right now in the center.